friends, welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new here. My name is Jen, I'm a certified weight loss and nutrition coach and I'm on the WW or the Weight Watchers Blue Plan. It's Saturday, so it is another grocery haul day. I went to Target and to Trader Joe's this week, lots of fun new food finds, and Trader Joe's came out with a pretty exciting new product this week that I bought so that I can share it with you. So if you're excited for today's video, give it a big huge thumbs up. And if you're new to my channel or you're not yet subscribed, of course, I would love to have you join my community. Take a moment and hit that little subscribe button and the bell next to it. That way you're notified whenever new videos are uploaded. I do a grocery haul every Saturday, so you definitely don't want to miss out. Check out that description box down below where you're going to find my 2021 custom calendar. Track your life, track your fitness, self-care, your food, and even your water. It is such an essential tool for 2021. It's the entire calendar for $15 and free shipping. It's not too late to order. I do ship same day, so you'll have it relatively quickly, and we're not even halfway through the month yet, so definitely pick up your 2021 calendar. While you're in the description box, you're going to find my nutrition coaching website where I offer personalized macros and calories, another really, really essential tool to have in your tool belt for 2021. It's important to know your calorie goal and your macro goal for all of the different nutrients, so definitely take advantage of that service. It's affordable and it's personalized to you. If you're looking for a little bit more one-on-one help, I do offer one-on-one nutrition coaching in both 30 and 60 minute sessions. So a little bit of everything over on my website, jenclaytonnutrition.com. Also, you'll find links and discount codes to all of my favorite things. And lastly, but certainly not least, link to head on over and join us on Facebook. We would love to have you be part of that community as well. It is very loving and supportive and just a great way to get lots of information, love, support, and even if you need a place to vent, it's a great place to do that as well. So head on over and join us. So we have a grocery haul to do, a meal plan and meal prep to go over, so let's jump in. This week's grocery haul, I went to Trader Joe's and to Target. I actually had a Target gift card and there were some really great deals on the Target app. If you have the app and a Target near you, there are some killer deals going on right now. So let me show you what I picked up for the week. For Troy's lunch, I picked up another box of the Entenmann's mini cherry pies. I was going to get his little muffins, but they didn't have them at Target, so I thought that I would change things up a little bit and surprise him with these little mini pies. He really likes these. They're small. They're the perfect size. They come 6 to a box individually wrapped. I stopped back by the Valentine's Day section because I have been craving Cheez-Its. My issue with Cheez-Its, I am very likely to overeat them. I just eat them out of the box. So I remembered seeing these when I was there last time. These are the Valentine's Day individual fun packs, 50 of them in a box for $8.99. They're 2 points per package. And I tend not to overeat prepackaged items because I generally don't go back for more. And that's one thing I like about having them prepackaged. I know they're usually more expensive. There's a little more waste, but it really helps me stay on track and within my points and calories a lot better. So I picked those up. I'm excited to have my Cheez-It fix. For meal prep this week, for dessert, I needed a box of classic yellow cake mix. Without an oven, we are improvising again for this week's meal prep, but I'm really excited about the recipes that I have coming your way without an oven. So I needed yellow cake mix. Dannon Light and Fit yogurt for both Troy and myself. This one isn't my favorite. He really likes it though, and I'm wanting him to take yogurts in his lunches again. These are on sale right now for $2.99 at Target. Ritz crackers for Troy. Again, he's on his meat, cheese, and cracker kick still. You'll see that I picked up meat and cheese for him for the week. And these are the family size, 6 stacks of Ritz. What's interesting about this is this box, which is double the amount that's in a regular box, was 50 cents more. So really watch your prices when it comes to standard size and family size. For his lunch this week, he wants soft tacos. So I have the Good & Gather organic flour tortillas. Also, at Target, if you spend $25 on Good & Gather products, you get $5 off. So basically, you get $5 worth of free groceries. So you'll see that I picked up a lot of Good & Gather this week. I saw that Target had the Alani Blue Slush. I've never tried this, but I wanted to give it a try. So I just picked up two. I've heard that it's really good for an energy drink. I'm not the biggest energy drink person. I really use them for emergency only. If I really just need a boost of energy, I like to have them on hand. I think I actually still have one in my refrigerator from the last two that I bought several weeks ago, but they only had a couple left, so I'll just pop them in the refrigerator. At Trader Joe's, I had to restock my onion salt. This is my favorite seasoning from Trader Joe's, hands down. I love it on eggs. I really love it on anything, so I picked that up. For Troy's Tacos, I grabbed three packages of the 73 27 ground beef. It was a dollar off per package, making it less than $3 a pound. He doesn't care about the fat content or if it's grass-fed or grass-finished like I do, so I picked up three of those so that I can make him his soft tacos. He also needed taco seasoning for those, so I have the Good & Gather traditional taco seasoning. We were all out of bread and butter pickles, which I love bread and butter pickles. To be honest with you, if I'm craving something sweet, this will do the trick, and it's only about 1 point for a ton of pickle chips, so I had to pick that up. And then for his meat, cheese, and crackers, they had the Good & Gather Colby Jack cracker cut slices, so these are already pre-cut, ready to go for him. Two cans of green beans for Diesel and Lola. They get this at the dinner table in place of table scraps. The last bag of orzo pasta in all of Target. I looked everywhere and this was thrown on a bottom shelf somewhere. It's not organic like I prefer, but you know what? It was the last bag in Target, so I picked it up. I actually need orzo for meal prep for lunches this next week. Of course, I picked up kombucha. I grabbed four bottles this week because I still have some left from last week. I got some of the Better Booch in my Imperfect Foods order, so I ended up having a surplus of kombucha this last week. But before it is gone, I picked up the fall edition of the Living in Gratitude, three of those, and a gingerberry. So these four bottles will get me through the week. For Troy's tacos, some sliced olives. He really likes to have olives on his soft tacos. A can of corn for a side dish for dinner. And then Trader Joe's just released, this is a brand new product this week, their grated Parmesan cheese. They've never carried their own grated Parmesan, and it was so cheap, $2.99 for this huge container, which is much less expensive than the Kraft or whatever the traditional brand of Parmesan cheese is. Two boxes of Good & Gather organic chicken broth. I needed those for a dinner recipe, and I forgot to buy the big case at Costco. Two packages of the Jones 10 Turkey Sausage Links. This is a great brand. They're all natural, fully cooked sausages. They're really, really low in smart points. I ended up buying two boxes because I need these for breakfast meal prep this week. Lots of cheese because we were running low. Some full fat Mexican style blend for Troy's soft tacos. My favorite organic mozzarella cheese from Trader Joe's. They do not have the light cheese. The guy at Trader Joe's said they don't anticipate bringing it back because the nutritional information was incorrect. So that's a little bit of a bummer, but this organic cheese is 1 point less than any other mozzarella cheese. So it's a little more pricey, but it tastes amazing. So if you have a Trader Joe's and you want to save a little points, but still eat a full fat cheese, pick that one up. I did also get a bag of the light Mexican blend cheese. For a dinner recipe, I needed some center cut bacon. So this is the Hormel Black Label center cut bacon. And then the same Italian dry salami that I picked up for Troy last week, I grabbed another pack of it at Trader Joe's for him. Organic boneless skinless chicken breast from Good & Gather. This was the only organic chicken they have at Target in the frozen section. It is thin slice, which makes me happy because I always end up slicing my chicken breast in half anyways, so I picked that up. My dogs loved this Trader Joe's Just the Salmon Skin. They went crazy over this. It is $2.99, not $3.99, so I picked up another package for them. And then Kid Fresh products are on sale on the Target app. These are my favorite nuggets. As you know, you can have a ton of nuggets for the smart points. They have vegetables in them and they are so good. So, so good. Pop them in your air fryer. Delicious. And then International Delight Coffee Creamer was on the Target app, so I picked up the birthday cake. I've never had this. I generally buy Coffee Mate, so this is the first time that I'm actually gonna have the International Delight brand. So hopefully I like it as much as the Funfetti from Coffee Mate. Sour cream for Troy's soft tacos, just the full fat sour cream. And then I picked up 2 packs of my favorite cottage cheese. This is the low fat, Good Culture. Target does not carry the full fat, but I needed it for a recipe this week. And so while I was there, I just went ahead and picked up 2 more of the low fat for snacking. Some frozen fruit at Trader Joe's, some organic raspberries because fresh raspberries are incredibly expensive. So I just pick these up that way whenever I'm feeling raspberries, I can defrost these or throw some frozen ones on yogurt or oatmeal. And then for my dessert recipe this next week, I needed frozen pineapple and frozen mango chunks. So I picked those up at Trader Joe's. Oh, and by the way, everything starting with the frozen fruit is all produce. I have a bag of organic mixed veggies and broccoli florets. You do not have to buy broccoli organic because it's on the Clean 15. So that's good news for that. So I picked those up for side dishes for this next week. Another bag of organic spinach for a recipe. I did decide to bite the bullet and buy some organic blueberries. These were $6.50, I think, but this is a good size package of blueberries. I think it's about 1 pound. Oh yeah, 1 pound, 2 ounces. So I'm gonna have blueberries for a fruit this week. Fresh basil for a recipe. I've been loving avocados. I got some in my Imperfect Foods box and I loved them. So I picked up another bag of avocados from Trader Joe's. These teeny tiny are awesome because you can eat the whole avocado. Because they're so small, you don't have to worry about saving the other half and it going brown. So I love the teeny tinies. And again, avocados are on the Clean 15, so you do not have to buy those organic either. A bag of organic lemons, shocker, for my water, some parsley for a recipe, and then lastly, some organic cremini mushrooms, also for a dinner recipe. So that is everything that I picked up for the week. Let's jump into what you'll see in meal prep and what I have on my meal plan with no oven for the next week. So here is what is on the agenda for this week's meal plan. My oven should be fixed by the end of the week. So 1 more week of no oven meal plan. So Saturday, we're going out to dinner / having some friends over for dinner. Sunday, I'm gonna be doing an Instant Pot Tuscan chicken pasta. So you guys will actually see this recipe in next Wednesday's What I Eat in a Day. Monday is cheesy meatball skillet. So this is a stovetop in a skillet recipe. Tuesday is a leftover night because now that we are back in studio for Jazzercise, I've been going every Tuesday, which seriously makes me so happy. Wednesday, I'm doing bacon, macaroni, and cheese. I'm really excited for this. Thursday is a zucchini mushroom chicken stir fry. So this again is done on the stovetop in a big stir fry wok. So I'm excited for that. And Friday I'll do leftovers and that way I can kind of finish up any leftovers from earlier in the week. So here is this week's meal prep. You guys will see all 3 of these recipes on Monday. For breakfast in my air fryer, I'm going to be making breakfast bombs. Stay tuned for this. These sound absolutely incredible. For lunch, I'm doing a cheesy chicken orzo. So this will be a really quick, easy lunch prep. And then for dessert in the slow cooker, I'm doing a Hungry Girl recipe, a tropical dump cake. So I'm really excited for that. I need some tropical vibes in my life in the winter. So you'll be seeing all 3 of these recipes on Monday in meal prep. Thank you for joining me on this week's WW Grocery Haul. I hope you enjoyed seeing what I picked up for the week, what's on the plan for Monday's meal prep, and the dinners that I'm making throughout this next week. I will be filming some of them, so you'll see them in future videos. So if you enjoyed this week's grocery haul, please give it a big, huge thumbs up. And of course, if you're new, welcome, welcome. Or if you're watching and you're not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? All you have to do is hit the little subscribe button and ring the bell next to it so you don't miss a single video. Don't forget about the 2021 custom calendar, nutrition coaching, macros and calories, links and discounts to my favorite things, and my Facebook group, all of which you'll find right down below the video in the description box. Thank you guys again so much for watching. Happy Saturday. Have a fabulous weekend, and I'll see you all in my next video.